Today I'm going to talk about the status bar at the bottom of your screen. Most people don't pay any attention to the status bar, but the status bar is full of useful information. So here I have a list of numbers on my screen. So let's just select these. And then if you look at the bottom, it has already calculated your average, your count, your sum. And then the other thing that we have here is we have the different view options available to you. So this is a normal view. You can go to page layout and you can go to page break preview. So this saves you a lot of steps as opposed to going to the view menu. The other thing that is here too, instead of going to all the steps to get to your developer tab, you can run a macro from here. So let's click on this one, and it asks you what you want to name the macro, and it's the same steps as if you'd gone to the developer tab and clicked on record a macro, but it's there for you already. So let's right click on the status bar here, and then it brings you up a list of things that are available for you on the status bar. Now most of them are checked already. I quite often have my cap locks on or my number lock for my, I forget to put my number lock on for my keypad, and I can't figure out why I'm doing all this, all these things that I don't particularly want. So let's, for example, put the cap locks on and the number locks on, and then we'll click away. So you can see that I have the number locks on. So let me take the number locks off, and it will disappear. Once again, I put it back on and you have the number locks on. So let me show you that if I put the cap locks on, it shows you that my cap locks are on. So you have all this information available. And I find when I'm selecting numbers and if I can get a quick sum or a quick average without having to go through the steps of calculating it, it's very handy. So this is a handy tool that you should use in your everyday work in Excel. Please subscribe.